Hi, welcome to vlog 93. I'm Joshua Kemble, and this is the vlog where I talk about Quarterly Stories, which is the graphic novel that I hand write, hand letter, and hand ink, and then hand to you, hopefully someday in print. But until that day, it's available serialized online at quarterlystories.com, and you can read it all the way up to this page, which I'm currently inking. Page 49, for your reading enjoyment at quarterlystories.com. It's a very personal story to me about faith and mental illness, and this is the vlog where I discuss the process and the progress of creating this graphic novel, on top of being a full-time art director, a full-time husband, and a full-time father. So, Benji's just gone to bed, which is my son, so I put him to bed because it's Thursday and this is my wife's night off. So generally what that means is, like, when I get home, I bathe Benji and do his bedtime routine and all of that fun stuff. And then, she gets some time to kind of read and collect herself because, you know, she works pretty hard throughout the week. Being a stay-at-home mom is a pretty tough job, so I figure it's the least I can do for her. So, so this week is kind of interesting. On Tuesday, this Tuesday, we had our Rock and Roll Tuesday, which is where my friend Josh and I get together and we play music together, and we write our own original songs. We've written about 3 songs. And we decided this week to try out a drummer, and actually it went really well. Really excellent drummer, and the jam session was like a lot of fun. And I think that it felt like one of those situations where we all kind of saw eye to eye musically, and we're kind of excited about playing music together. So. So that's pretty cool. So I think we actually might have a drummer. And I didn't want to record any of the stuff we were doing because, you know, I want to give like a new member time to kind of learn the songs and figure out what parts they want to play. I mean, obviously most of what I've played you guys in the past that my friend and I are doing are all going to be modified slightly as they go anyway, because they're songs. And during the like crafting stage, it's like all songs kind of change a little bit. But, you know, I think it would be intimidating if you were just trying out with a new band to, you know, be recorded and put on YouTube. So I spared him the that. But one thing I will say that was really cool from playing with the drummer was, like, it kind of revived or reminded me, like, how much fun it is to be in a band, because something about adding that rhythm just really makes it a very cool experience. So that was, like, that was Tuesday. And then what happened Wednesday, so then I got home from that and I inked these parts of the panel. I was just hit with total exhaustion. And what I noticed was, like, the next day, my allergies and stuff just were insane. I hadn't really slept a lot, and kept having these weird allergy attacks at night. And so, like, it just kind of caught up with me, so I had to call out from work. And basically just, you know, I had to, like, I haven't done a vlog. And so... anyhow, the point being, like, I ended up kind of missing a day of work on my comic and on my vlog. And so, so one of the things I'm hoping to kind of do tonight is to catch up a little bit. So my goal is to, like, hopefully finish this panel. And then after I've finished this panel, you know, like, hopefully maybe finish the other panel, like, to the left of it. It's a pretty easy panel, and this panel is pretty far along so far. So we'll see how that goes. And I'm going to do this as like a long form vlog where I talk while I'm inking, and then hopefully upload this tonight and get back on the train of, you know, constant updates on YouTube and stuff. So another little thing that's been interesting is it's been super busy at work, and yet like the creative team that I work with feels like it's really gelling, and it just kind of feels like we're a pretty good unit right now, and I'm really thankful for that. It's a nice feeling that when you go to the workplace to kind of have what feels like a pretty cohesive unit. But it's been super busy, so on top of, you know, just regular typical exhaustion, because I'm always working on projects at home, I'm trying to kind of spend as much time as I can with my son and with my wife, and then on top of that to be working full time and then commuting for about 3 hours a day, it just, you know, I don't want to sound like I'm complaining, because I actually really appreciate my life and appreciate these extra things that I have. But you know, I like, on top of, you know, appreciating all of that stuff, it's nice to, it's nice to be busy because it means we're making profit, but sometimes it's kind of exhausting trying to juggle everything. And I know I've gotten into that on this vlog before. It's just one of those really hard things about, you know, I think honestly any personal projects or self-improvement of any kind is very difficult to do. Because it's like the better you get at it, like the more it becomes like you kind of cracked open this Pandora's box, and you're just not able to have a lot of time to work on projects. So anyhow, let's see what else. There's just been some interesting things that have come up. One thing that surprised me about yesterday, and it always kind of never fails to surprise me, is like how dependent we are on our minds being 100%. And I think I've mentioned this before in this vlog, but it's fascinating to me like how much, you know, just one day of feeling a little off can kind of throw off the whole thing. And it makes you really appreciate like being at a point where, you know, you're conscious enough and aware enough to like be able to do these side things. So that's been pretty awesome. Another interesting thing is this part that I'm in on my comic is starting to get to that place where I'm feeling kind of uncomfortable with what's being written. And I think I've talked about this on the vlog before, but it's kind of like something I want to do in writing autobiographical stuff is write things that aren't necessarily comfortable to write and don't necessarily paint me in the best light. And I feel like I'm actually getting to a territory like that in my comic, because there was a point where I was, you know, working on the lettering of this, and I was like, wow, I come across really badly in this part. And yet it's funny, because to be true to the story and true to kind of who I was at the time in this story, I have to kind of depict myself as not the best person, like more kind of a pseudo-victim kind of character. And that's pretty interesting, because there's a really kind of neat element to working on autobio, and it's slightly like time travel in a weird way. You're like having to kind of time travel and see who you were at the time you were writing about. And not just that, but like, you're also trying to kind of be objective and not too subjective. But then I'm writing this in first person, so how do you be objective when you're writing in first person and yet come across as though you are subjective? Like, so you come across like it's your own experience and trying to be genuine to like who you were at the time, but at the same time with the knowledge that you have now, and trying to kind of apply that, somehow stay true to it. And I mean, it's such an absurd notion, like the idea of even trying to do truth in comics. It can be kind of a weird one, you know? I mean, we all kind of remember our experiences differently. And so a lot of the time, like, our memory can really do wonderful tricks on us and kind of skew what actually happened in our lives. And then even what we remember very clearly, you know, is still stuck in our own perspective. So it makes for this really fascinating thing in autobio. And I think that I've gotten into this before, but I think there's a slight responsibility when you're taking on autobio to not just use it as a platform to kind of self-aggrandize, but to try to depict truth and, if anything, exaggerate your own flaws. Because I think that makes for a compelling, more honest narrative, but it's really hard to say, because like I said, the whole idea of honest narratives is kind of a subjective thing. So it's kind of funny, but that's just something I've been thinking about when working on this page. But I'm also happy to be at a point where I'm writing something I'm not comfortable with. I've had a few moments like that when working on this comic, and each time I've had those, I feel like it's actually heading into story areas that are probably pretty interesting. If it's something the character, you know, or, you know, the character who's me in the past is revealing that isn't necessarily something I'm proud of, I feel like that it's kind of heading into the right direction. So, and I've explained it before. I mean, like, I love American Splendor and a lot of Harvey Pekar, R. Crumb, and I feel like they kind of share those qualities of kind of like candid, almost confessional. You know, not the only genre I read or anything, but it's definitely, for some reason, seems like the genre I want to write. But anyhow, so it's just fun to get to these points in the story where I'm like, man, I'm gonna seem like a jerk. I think that's, I guess I'm being kind of redundant, but I think that's probably a good area to head into. For those of you who like do stories and are working on stories or working on comics, like, you know, have you guys ever dipped into autobiographical stuff? And if you did, would you go into territories that are kind of uncomfortable to write? Just kind of curious. 'Cause I've met people who, like, some people think it's fairly easy to do that because you're kind of pooling from things that happen, so your plot is kind of more a matter of editing than it is a matter of inventing. So you're kind of having to edit out unessentials and try to kind of come in and edit like those moments so that they aren't just arbitrary, but they actually have a story arc to them. But at the same time, you aren't having to do a lot of inventing. So that's one take I've heard on it. And the other take is a lot of people think it's kind of scary to get into writing this type of stuff. And I'm kind of somewhere in between. I think there's also a freedom in being able to invent your own plot that that's kind of nice. And I think you can be pretty bold with, like, your own plot, to where you're maybe revealing some things about yourself that you're uncomfortable with, but through masks and layers. And sometimes that might be more effective, right? Because it doesn't come across as, like, narcissistic. But, I don't know, to me, it's like, for my own story right now, like I said, I'm kind of happy to start getting to pages that I'm not so happy to be writing. That might be insane, but I really do firmly think, like, that's the right territory if you're doing this kind of thing. So I'm using a brush. What's interesting, I've been struggling with my brush lately. I use a Pantone Pocket brush pen, and I keep feeling like it's on its last legs, but I also know that it's kind of got a little bit of juice left. Like, the ink is kind of running low on it. So I know that, like, once I replace the ink, it'll run a lot smoother. But it is kind of interesting, because I, for some reason, feel like I've been struggling with the brush a little more this week. That kind of weirds me out too, because you'd think after doing so many pages, you know, you'd be like super comfortable with your material and medium, but it's funny because I still have these off days where I feel like, man, I used to be able to nail this kind of thing with a brush pretty quickly. And that also makes me wonder if, like, maybe it is just, like, the brush is getting drier, so it's not flowing as easily. I don't know. Do you guys ever have that when you work with your medium? Like, like, those moments where you're like, I have this down, and then, like, suddenly you're like, what the hell am I doing? Kind of thought I knew, but here I am refiguring it out. All right, so I'm getting closer to finished with this panel, and I'm pretty excited that on Tuesday I did manage to get a little bit of work done. It wasn't quite as much as I usually would hope, but because we were trying out a drummer, it went a little bit longer on Tuesday than it usually would. So that put me behind a little bit, and then just the being sick the next day. But it's so funny, because it's like, once you built a habit like this, being sick kind of sucks twice as much, because you're like, you kind of want to work on your personal projects, and when your head's just not quite in a space where it can work on, like, you know, heavy motor skill stuff, like, you know, like inking. I think that's a motor skill. But anyhow, when your mind can't really focus on those kind of skills, it's a very, very fascinating and kind of frustrating experience. Because you, like, know how to do it. And then it's like, you're also just watching as you making this great progress and having really good momentum, and then it's kind of put to a halt. So, alright. So, I gotta just do this background. How's this coming out? Can you guys see? I hope you guys can see. So, another weird thing happened Tuesday before we tried out the drummer. And it's this weird thing that I felt for, like, a little bit, because we actually really wanted drummer, you know? And And it was like this brief moment of like almost fear. Well, we were gonna try out this new guy, and I think that was kind of interesting. Like, I wasn't quite expecting to have that, because as I've explained before, like, this music project's kind of a passion project. It's nothing like super serious. It's definitely not unserious. Like, we're trying to write really good music, but you know, I don't think any of us are kind of putting it as like our number one priority in life or anything. But it's funny because we're trying out this drummer, and played in bands for years and stuff, so shouldn't be a big deal. But I was all of a sudden really nervous and kind of hoping that things would work out. And I realized, I think it's because we haven't really had like a band in quite a few years, so there was a little bit of risk involved, you know. And anytime you kind of put yourself out there or take a chance on something, there's a fear of failure with it. So it was funny to experience that, because I think we all experience that at some point when we're trying something new that's creative. Like this kind of innate, sort of weird, strange fear. And it's almost like a fear of failure and an equal fear of, like, success. Because, like, crap, well, so we get a drummer, like, now we gotta actually have a band and maybe play some shows and, like, you know? I know it's silly. It's like, that's kind of what I want, but it's also, like, fascinating, because it's like, I think we're equal parts afraid of not succeeding in it, and you know, also afraid of succeeding, because like, what happens if it does well? And that's something I've thought about with like this comic too. Like, I'm definitely prepared for it not doing well. I mean, I'm gonna give it a shot to kind of launch this thing and try to get it out there and stuff, so I'm pretty prepared for, like, if it doesn't sell a lot, or if it sells okay, you know. But I'm definitely not prepared for it succeeding, like, a ton. And there is a part of me that's, like, a little nervous about that, if I'm being honest. And I think that's pretty fascinating, like, where it's, like, where does that come from, you know? Like, this fear of actually succeeding. And yet I think it's kind of there innately. It's like, wow, because then if you succeed, then like, you actually have to still do it, and usually it'll mean more responsibility and more like newer problems, maybe not harder, but definitely new problems, a lot of newness involved in success. So that can be scary, you know. Which, like, I'm still kind of in a bit of a mind fog from the getting sick, like, the day before. So some of this was very, like, mind foggy, the way I'm sharing this, you know? So I'm really trying to, you know, take my time on backgrounds. It's always really tempting, especially at this stage, just kind of gun it on a background, because you have all your figures drawn, you know? And if you're like me, like, the figure's the fun part, the background's kind of like the extra. So it's like, it's tempting to just kind of phone in the background. But then, like, I don't know, like, one of the things I've been enjoying about this comic that I'm working on is that I've been spending time on the backgrounds, so that hopefully they'll at least bring a little more to it than And just like if I say, like, filled it with black and a bunch of floating heads. So. So, kind of getting closer to done with this panel. So I know that I also haven't been updating my blog as frequently as I had in the last few days. And part of that's due to the sickness. And so I'm hoping to be more consistent with these updates, which probably sounds pretty old right now, because I seem to be saying that every once in a while. But I hope you guys can tell, like, I am trying pretty hard to get these out as often as possible, and hopefully keep them as entertaining as possible. But it's kind of tough on a day like today, where I'm kind of getting back from being slightly sick. And to be honest, like, I'm really pumped to work on my comic, but I'm pretty, like, dry for topics. And it's funny, because it's like I'm not, like, dry for topics all the time with things, but for some reason, just that brain fog of sickness. One thing I will say, I have been really inspired by a lot of the YouTube community, particularly some of the people working on the hundreds and their output. It kind of always makes me want to up my game and keep delivering content. And it's funny, because even like with the vlog or whatever, I feel like I'm having a really consistent week where I'm updating a lot, and I'll look and there's always someone who's doing it a little more. And it's kind of like, I kind of like that about YouTube, because it feels a little bit like a bullpen of sorts, where it's like, you know, well, you might be feeling good about your output of, like, you know, a page every 2 weeks or something. And then, like, there's a few people I follow on social media, one in particular who's like making like more than a page a day, and, you know, balancing that on top of like a full-time thing. And it's just like, man, when I see that, it makes me want to just gun it and work on pages and stuff. But it's also just like kind of the reality of the industry and who we are. Like, there are some people who have a higher output. Now, that doesn't mean it's because they have it easier. It just means, A, maybe they're sacrificing more to get it done, or B, it's a mix of both. Like, they are a little faster, but they're faster because they've sacrificed so much to get there. I don't know. But, like, the thing that's funny is, like, I think, like, 10 years ago, the person I was would have probably not taken that well. I used to be a really competitive person, and, like, kind of unhealthily so. So I would, like, I was kind of like, I know it's weird, I'm not like this much anymore. I have a few times, but not a lot. But I definitely was one of those people who, like, if I had a friend who, like, succeeded in art, I'd be happy for them, but I'd also, like, beat myself up for not being where they were, you know? And I think in a weird way, like, unhealthily, like, I didn't celebrate other people's successes with them as much as I should have. And I definitely am that way now. Like, nowadays, I'm really proud of my friends who succeeded and my friends who do better than me at stuff. Like, I'm actually pretty happy for them. Like, I'm kind of stoked that it's also like really cool to know them, because it's like neat to know these people who are like so talented and amazing. And also it can really be a nice boost to your motivation to make stuff. But it's funny how, like I said, like 10 years ago, I think I was kind of destructive with that type of thing, because I would get kind of competitive and like I said, it almost inhibited my ability to like really enjoy other people's successes. I think that's a pretty common thing with like younger artists. And I think, you know, I mean, it makes sense. It's like it's a tough industry. So, you know, the people who do make it are making it work somehow. I think inevitably, like, a lot of people who are really trying hard and not seeing a lot of return, you know, might get envious. But, like, I really want to reiterate, like, it's so much better for your own sanity and stuff to like actually to really start learning how to celebrate other people's successes. And partially too because the people that you know who succeed, like, they need friends and people in their lives too. And I think inevitably it's a much healthier thing to be in a friendship or a relationship where you can you know, celebrate each other's successes and kind of view it as like a journey to get there together. Why am I bringing that up? I guess I'm bringing that up because I have been having these moments of like seeing these guys that I know just knock out pages. And like I said, it's super encouraging. And it's also cool because, like I said, it kind of lights a fire a little bit to, like, well, I might feel like I'm doing a lot, but I can do a lot more. There's a lot of these people doing a lot more. But also, realistically, like, you know, there are things I've chosen that limit that amount of time to work on things. So it's a mix, you know. It's a mix. So I'm getting closer to finish with this panel, and I'm pretty excited about that because, like, today was definitely one of those days where, because I was sick yesterday, by the time my son was in bed, I was like, my brain was very much telling me just like, you can work on your comics anytime, just relax, don't burn out, you know, you need to recover and feel better. And yet somehow I powered through that thought, and now here I am, like, a little bit closer to finished with this crazy panel. I really am looking forward to doing the last panel on this page. That looks like the most fun to ink of all of them. And I'm kind of excited about getting to that fun stuff. It's like a lot of texture and detail on a face. I love drawing faces. I think that's what got me into art in the first place, was like trying to kind of capture a face. So I remember like filling entire sketchbooks over and over again with just eyes. Just the human eye, and I'd just draw it over and over and over again until I felt like I was getting an idea of how it worked and how to draw it, how to cartoon it and simplify it and stuff. And a lot of sketchbooks of hands. Like filling a lot of just drawing pages with stuff I really was no good at drawing. Objects, backgrounds, cars. Cars are still a struggle. Which is funny because I know some guys who like cars is like their faces. Like cars is what got them into drawing. They wanted to be like those muscle car guys. Dudes who just do like airbrush renderings of cars and stuff. And like, some of them were so good at drawing cars, and then the human figure just not so great. But it's, I don't know, it's fascinating to me. Like, there are some people who are like really comfortable with doing backgrounds and stuff like that, but then when it comes to like a face or a head, they're not so competent. And it's just interesting how each person has their thing. Although I do think the face thing is a pretty common thing to like get you into drawing, because the human face is, it's kind of a challenge to capture, and then capturing a likeness is even harder. I do kind of feel like this hair is just too light. So I kind of want to do a little bit of blacking it out, just to give a little more depth to this page. All right, here we go, just finishing this wall. So, getting closer to done with this panel. So for artists out there who are listening to this vlog, what do you guys do to make up for sick days? Like, you know, as human beings, we all get sick. Some of us more so than others. I mean, I think maybe like eating better and stuff like that would be pretty a good road to like not getting sick as often. But anyhow, so when you guys have like a sick day, like what do? Do you kind of make up for it by working kind of like double on your personal projects, or do you allow yourself some sick days? You know, like, just how do you kind of work sick days into your schedule? I personally have like a not so, probably a not so good method, which is if I miss a day, I usually try to do twice the work the next day. Just to kind of keep myself in the flow of, it's easier to get the like little bit done today than it is to get twice as much done next. But you know, maybe sometimes that's not so healthy. Anyhow, so what do you guys do? Wonder if you guys take like a sick day or something. Okay. Getting a little closer to finished. So, it's weird, but I really have grown to like hatching with a brush. And I almost wonder, like, if quill is kind of similar. The thing I like about the brush is just kind of the ability to get that bounce of that thick and thin. But also, it's not like so consistent that it's like boring, like a micron would be in the cases of these hatch marks and stuff. It's got a little more wobble to it, variation. I personally like that. Oddly enough, though, like for hatching, probably might be quicker to do it with a micron. But for some reason, I just really like the feel of this pocket brush pen. And the control I have over it. It's kind of a good thing. All right. So there we go. Kind of hope that that's background enough. I think that I'd like to have some of this just a little bit, and then go to black just to make it kind of work a little better. Here we go. Yep. Cool. That'll do it for one panel. So now I'm gonna take a very brief break. Get a water. Pause this, and then hopefully I'll get to this as well. Okay, so I'm back and I'm gonna try to do this last panel, and then I will be caught up for what I missed when I was sick, which is kind of ideal. So if I can catch up on what I did when I was sick, then hopefully, that will get me where I need to be on the page with just one panel left, so that hopefully by tomorrow. I'm hoping that I can maybe even finish inking page 49 and be on my way to 50, which would be really cool. This is kind of a weird page because I'm not trying really hard not to put too much detail on the face or on the body. We're watching my sister-in-law's dog, and so the dog needs a little encouragement to take his night break. So that's what you're hearing in the background.
Did you go? Huh? You don't look like you did. That was pretty fast. Come on. Let's try again. Did you go, baby?
The fun of little dogs. Okay, so, basically just laying out the contour lines. And the nice thing about that, about like doing the contour lines and stuff, is just, like once that's done, it's all brushwork, which is pretty fun. So it's like getting through all the hard labor. So I'm thinking I'm not even going to have this ground line because I want this to be a really blank panel so you really feel the isolation of the character. And it's going to be interesting to see if I can kind of pull that off. But I do think that the panel will be better served without that line. And then once I erase that line, then like, I don't know, I've even thought about getting rid of the border on this panel altogether. So I'm gonna kinda see how it works once the figure is inked in. I'd like this shadow a lot, so I'm gonna definitely do that, but I'm not sure whether this even needs a panel border. Although I kind of like the building. I always view like cartooning as like you're almost like making a song or creating like a tempo. And so in this one, it's like a really kind of repetitive build up, and then it gets to this this big kind of sustain, be like the last panel. And to me, I definitely want this to not lose that build up, but I also want this panel to feel very, very isolated. It's kind of very strong shadow cast against like a white. That's what I'm kind of hoping for, but we'll see. This needs a little more. I wonder if that's gonna do it. I actually am thinking maybe that's a good time to get rid of that border altogether. Funny, I used to like use like pearl white other other tools to kind of lay down weight. What I've actually found for myself, I know it's not like archival, but nothing beats like a decent just little like old whiteout pen. Definitely reeks though. Yeah, that was the right choice. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Without the border. I think that's gonna make the pacing of this just solid as hell. So we're just getting rid of this border. Some of this will probably get flubbed up when I get to erasing the pencils, but the beauty of that is, first off, I always have more white out. Second off, I have a computer. So when I get to clean up, I can clean up. I try really hard not to use any kind of correctional stuff though, like overlays or anything like that, but sometimes it does not hurt to kind of have as a little backup. Especially in cases like this where I'm like, no, this really needed to just be a blank panel. Yep. Okay, so I have finished the page. Thanks for watching, and thanks to those of you who have commented, liked, shared, or subscribed to my channel, especially subscribing. It helps the channel keep going. And I'll show you the page real quick, and then I'm going to actually catch some sleep so that I can fully recover from being sick. I hope you guys are having a productive art week, and I will see you guys next week. So here's page 49 so far. Character's on the couch. Other character walks in, walks up to the couch. New character, close-up of the character, is kind of trying to do a little Renaissance-style pose here. Me in the background, closer shot, further. And then this one will be just white, so these little lines are going to be erased entirely. And I think that's a much more effective page. So, yeah. I'll get a little more done tomorrow. I'm hoping tomorrow I'll be able to ink this hardcore puppy. So, all right, I will see you guys next week.